All right, students. So let's come to question number 6. Question number 6 states that sulfide ores are common for the metals. Now this is a fairly simple question from the chapter of metallurgy, which expects us to know the names of the ores of those elements which occur as sulfides. So the correct answer for this question would be A, because the ores of all these three elements, that is Ag, Cu and Pb, they always occur as sulfides. For example, the ore of Ag is Ag2S, which is also called argentite. This is the name of the ore. The ore of Cu is Cu2S, called copper glance, or one more ore is there which is called CuFeS2, the name of this ore being copper pyrites. This is the name of the ore. And for lead, which is very very popular, the ore for Pb is PbS, called common name galena. This is the name of the ore. So as we can see, all the three ores, PbS, Cu2S, Ag2S, are sulfides. Let's move to next question, which is question number 7. Question number 7 is from the chapter of surface chemistry. Let's read the question carefully first. It says, methylene blue from its aqueous solution is adsorbed on activated charcoal, right, at 25 degree centigrade. For this process, the correct statement is. Now we have been given four options. First, let us quickly recall that adsorption is of two categories or two varieties. One is called chemisorption and the other is called physisorption, and the other is called physisorption. So these are the two kinds of adsorption which we have studied. Okay, so as we know that the adsorption of methylene blue is physical in nature. Physical in nature means the binding forces of attraction, are van der Waal forces. They are van der Waal forces and it's not a chemical bond. Okay. So in option A, it says the adsorption requires activation at 25 degree centigrade. No, that's not right. In option B, it says the adsorption is accompanied by a decrease in enthalpy. Now this happens to be the correct answer, because whenever adsorption occurs, the delta H for an adsorption process is always negative. Why is this so? This is because in adsorption process there is always a force of attraction due to which things get close together, right? So since things get close together and there is a force of attraction, there is a decrease in the overall surface energy. And if energy is decreasing, then that means some energy will be released and delta H will be zero. So that leaves us with option B. If we just happen to read option C and D as well, the adsorption increases with increase of temperature. No, that's not right. The extent of adsorption will always decrease with increase of temperature. And the adsorption is irreversible. No, that's also not right. D option is wrong, as well as C option is also wrong, because it's an example of, as I said before, physisorption. And physisorption is always reversible in nature. So that leaves us with the only correct answer, that is B. Thank you.